What is up, my tender tulips? Today we're jumping back into what remains of Edith Finch. If you remember last time, all these family members on screen now, except Edith, I found random stories about them. Molly turned into different animals and then was eaten by herself as a monster? Barbara, we just found out, was eaten by monsters. Calvin flew off the swing and just disappeared. And Odin, well, he was just weird. He set the house on a big boat and then it drowned. It drowned? Houses don't generally drown. It sank and he drowned. So let's jump back in and find out what happened to the rest of the family.
I guess now I know why Mom didn't like me playing with the music box.
Yes. There was also a secret key in the music box I didn't know of. But now I do.
Funny. All those times I played with the music box and never found the basement key.
It's like they're trying to remind me because I was walking around aimlessly. I wonder, if I deliberately go this way, are they going to give me another hint? Oh boy, that music box. I forgot there was a key in there all along, but I just found out about... Maybe I should see if there's a key. No? Okay. Then let's just grab the key. Yeah. Dum 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 dum. Pretty bougie family with a pool table, but then it's also hella bougie to have shortcuts and secret passages in your house.
Mom said the basement was off limits, unless I wanted another tetanus shot.
Hey, it's the little dragon. A smaller version of the big dragon what killed the man. That's what he apparently fell on.
I saw Edie sneak down to the basement once, carrying packages.
Packages, you say? That could mean anything.
I thought she was hiding presents.
Oh. What?
It turned out she was hiding a lot more than that.
Secret doorways? I had no idea. There's been none of those yet. Oh, too dark. Oh God, it's like a proper cave.
I remember asking Mom where Walter had gone. She said after Barbara died, he got as far away as he could.
Jesus.
Is there a pattern in all these stories?
What a proper shelter.
I think it's that none of us has gotten very far.
Oh.
Goodbye, everyone. I can't believe I've been down here for 30 years.
Jesus.
On that first day, after the shaking started, I didn't think I'd survive the week.
Oh no, Sailor Man.
But after a few days, I settled into a routine.
This could
That's what kept me sane.
Just like a story, if not for the fact that the game occasionally makes me do stuff
Having
like turn a tin opener.
Living for today.
It's the only thing that makes it a game. But I'm enjoying it.
I always expected to be dead tomorrow. But if you wait long enough, you'd be used to anything.
Come on. Open the tin opener.
Even a monster on the other side of the door starts to feel normal. Almost friendly.
Definitely not friendly. She was eating peaches.
And then one day, everything just stopped. Whatever that thing was, it was gone. Maybe.
Oh, I like that the reflection's on the top of the clock.
Or maybe I just got tired of being afraid. It's been a week now, the longest in 30 years. I'm done waiting. I have to leave while I still can.
Oh, down here. Why would you leave downwards and not upwards. I suppose I don't know the layout quite as well as Walter does. What's that? Alvino's. Extra crispy.
I know it's out there somewhere. Whatever killed Barbara.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he was the kid who...
And Calvin.
...hid from the monsters, which killed Barbara.
Maybe this is all a mistake.
No monsters killed Calvin. I thought he flew over the trees.
But I need to stop living the same day. Even if it kills me.
I do like the way they show this font, and that's kind of...
Whatever's out there, I want you to know...
How it tells you where to go next. Or gives you a clue. I
appreciate all of it, especially the food.
I don't mind. You appreciate running.
Or a month. Or a single week. I'd be happy with one more day.
Ah, oh, so beautiful. I thought the shaking was a bloody train. What a stupid way to go.
Walter died when I was 6. I can't believe my mom never told me he was down here.
Why would she? I like that they put his can opener as kind of a shrine.
I'm sure my mom was trying to protect me.
What a beautiful fake view. Now, I need to be very careful down here. Because we've just seen there's a big metal monster. Go!
Maybe she was afraid I'd end up like Walter.
Go, Edith, go!
But if she never told me about an uncle under the house...
What else didn't she tell me?
Can you imagine what else she was hiding?
Here we go.
I don't want to make the same mistakes she made. Trying to bury something that's still alive. Now that there's only one of us left, or maybe two, I thought it was time I heard the stories for myself.
I wonder if the first brother we heard of is still alive somewhere. Milton? Yeah.
But now I'm worried the stories themselves might be the problem.
Oh, no.
Maybe we believed so much in a family curse, we made it real.
Why does he get two memorials? There's tiny little people. Well, I definitely can't go down there, so let's go here.
I don't know if I should even be writing this. Maybe it'd be better if all this just died with me.
Yeah, here are some weird statues I saw.
But I thought you should know about your family.
That is creepy.
And the history you're a part of.
Oh, it's gonna make me go in the sewers, isn't it? Yeah, it's not letting me go anywhere else. But I can't go in there. Now what? Oh, is there?
To be honest, I feel as lost as you probably do right now. I think the people in these stories believed them, for what that's worth.
This slow walking is going to be the death of me.
And when you look at the house, that history
is a hella cool house.
Stubbornness and madness. Any of it seems possible.
Is there anything here for me? Gary's potting mix. Who the hell is Gary?
I think we've been surrounded by death for so long, we've just gotten used to it. What kind of family finishes building a cemetery before starting the house?
Yeah. Doesn't seem like the best idea, does it?
It's embarrassing for me to admit this, but The pet cemetery may be more uncomfortable than the human one. Three of the gerbils are mine, and two had been my fault.
Ah. Zerpy, Lurpy, Furpy, Chirpy, Burpy, Derpy, Derpy Jr. Bob, Shadow, Christopher. Aw, oh, Christopher the Fish. Molly probably should have just ate it.
Sven built the house, but it was Edie who designed the cemetery.
Walter was train guy. Edie, we don't know yet. Sven was granddad. Calvin was shot over here on his, swing. Molly said she turned into a cat, and there's a cat on her grave. Just saying, Barbara was the star.
I'm sure Odin's monument had been Edie's idea. My mom was always trying to move on, but for Edie, the past never went away.
And this is the idiot.
She could see it poking out of the water at low tide.
Oh, that's the house. Jesus.
Edie said she dreamed about the old house every night.
Now what?
Edie's side was always easier for me to understand.
Ah.
But the older I get, the more I can see where my mom was coming from. Her dad had been pretty strict, but it wasn't enough to save her brothers. She was just trying to do better.
Gregory. That's the funny number. Is that a paintbrush?
She lost two of her brothers, just like I did. I get why she tried so hard to protect us.
Looks kind of like the Golden Crown. Sanjay Kumar is not a Finch. Who is he?
We never found Milton's body, so my mom insisted we were putting up a monument, not a tombstone.
Fair. Ugh. Walking is so slow.
I could ask my mom now. Part of me thinks this is what she wanted all along. For me to come back someday and find everything out for myself.
Klein.
But looking back on
it now, what a delightful little treehouse.
If she told me there was going to be so much climbing, I never would have come when I was 22 weeks pregnant.
Oh, she is fat. But, you know, pregnancy fat, so that makes sense.
I never met Grandpa Sam, but I think he and my mom had a lot in common. They were both pretty intense.
Nice rug. Come on, Sam. Ah, that looks like a wedding ring.
Oh, he's got the mustache. He looks like an American.
Dawn, I promise, you'll never forget this weekend.
Yes, sir.
These memories are going to last a lifetime.
Mm-hmm. Am I going to have to shoot anything?
It's a hunting trip, Dawn. Shooting is strongly encouraged.
What?
Dawn.
Perfect.
It's going to rain the whole weekend, isn't it?
You don't know that.
Never forget this weekend, Dad.
That's the spirit. Okay, got it.
Odin Finch National Park.
I'm gonna take some pictures, okay?
Just be careful. The camera's older than you are.
Who's the bird? If the camp's that.
You're right, Dad. It's starting to clear up. Still freezing, though.
What'd you say, you ungrateful bitch? Am I supposed to be more birds? Ah, crocodiles! or logs.
I should not have drunk all that coffee.
Where you at, old man? Oh.
Nothing quite like peeing outside.
Yeah, take a picture of your dad taking a pee.
That's
normal.
Hold still while I take a picture of you.
I'm just saying, I'm not always going to be here, Don. You'll need to remember this stuff, if you want to survive.
I'll be fine, Dad.
You know who else thought he was going to be fine?
Dad!
Good eyes, Don.
Gotcha.
Before you take the shot, let me get a picture of you.
Well...
Dad, I...
Just breathe.
Cool. You're taking a lifelong picture. First time she kills another creature.
Do I have to do this?
Don, you don't have to do anything. But if you want to survive, you'll need to be strong.
That's a cool shot.
Great shot, Don!
Ooh, what a picture. There's no vegans.
I'm proud of you, Don. Always remember that, okay?
Oh. Suppose I'll run to you.
Dad, it's twitching. I think
that's
it's
totally
so...
normal, Don. Just focus on the camera. Try not to think about...
Dad!
Oh. Bye, Sam. I hope that's not how he died.
Of all these stories, that's the one I wish most that my mom had told me.
That is sad. Like, in front of his daughter, and he made it through the war and died to a stag.
Sam spent his life shooting photos, but mom said he got nervous being in front of the camera. I guess we're all afraid of something.
What a loser.
Instead of hiding from death, Sam seemed to go out of his way to meet it.
What else you got in here, Sam? Any cool stuff? You got any guns? To another secret passage!
After Sam died, my mom and Edie got really close. They'd both lost a lot.
This one is just a child gate. Uh-oh, that's a strange-looking kid. He's only a year old. Jeez, this game. Oh, divorce.
Dear Kay, do you remember the way Gregory used to laugh when he thought he was alone? Like, something funny was happening, but only he could see it. I think he saw things the rest of us don't.
He's controlling the duck.
That's hand over, Gregory. It's time to...
Aww.
Hold on, sweetie.
He's playing with the frog.
Hello? Sam, I told you I didn't want to talk right now.
Duckies!
I wonder what he saw.
Duckies, I am apparently unable to get. Got one!
What is
I got two!
Like? Reminded me so much of Calvin.
That's cool.
Lost in his imagination. Whatever it was, he saw.
That's.
It sure made him happy.
Do I need to be on the whale? Oh, I need to tip the whale. Come on. Screw you, Gregory. Yes.
But I worried about a baby being too happy. I can feel her slipping away.
Sorry about that, Gregory.
Oh.
I know you did everything you could. Maybe if I hadn't called that night.
I don't want Gregory to hear this.
Ah.
I wish he could have told us.
Oh no. Sad
about Gregory, about everything.
So he drowned.
But I know what happened wasn't your fault. I'm sure it's
him. Yay.
He'd want you to be happy too. Good luck, Kay. Love, Sam.
That is a horrible thing to put for divorce papers. There's a big space to the right. I guess there's no one else in here. Dawn. Gus.
Cool kid with a skateboard. Poetry and yet.
Oh man, he's like a little red mohawk. Sky looks wild.
A poem for Gus, who always said the wedding was a bad idea. Our father never hit us kids, at least not very hard, before the day my brother said with teenage disregard that he'd be dead before he'd see a wedding in our yard.
Whoa!
My father made him come, of course, but Gus stood far apart, just flew his kite and bottled up the storm inside his heart. I tried to talk him out of it, but though he'd never met her, we don't need a stepmom, were the words that I now pronounce
you husband and wife. See. Make his cry. Ah.
When the time for photos came, Dad ordered him to come here. But Gus declined, and as a sign, held up his middle finger.
Nice. I like this Gus kid.
The wind picked up, and panicked geese appeared and quickly went. But all the humans did that day was go inside the tent.
Except for Gus, who flew his kite like an absolute G.
The rain came down in buckets then, but no one seemed afraid that nature might destroy the tent our dad had crudely made.
Whoa!
The thunder sounded much too close and full of angry power. But all my father said to this was, make the music louder.
Man after my own heart. I'm kind of having more fun just destroying all this. This kite is, like, unbeatable. Ah, throw that. Oh. Uh-oh.
I wish that I could truly say I thought about you on that day. Out there on the beach alone, just you, the wind, the sea, and foam. But I didn't. Until we found you.
Who? Poor Gus.
She never talked about him, but Mom told me once if I was a boy, they were going to name me Gus.
Dead. Yes, he is. Don't need to rub it in. Raise flag, breakfast, quiet time. Dawn, sweep, trash, Gus, mop, mow, yard, Greg, be a baby. Greg did being a baby good. I think that's probably done there. This is cool. I got a damn climbing wall.
My mom moved up to the loft after her brothers died.
I didn't mean to rhyme, but it did.
At the time, it was as far away as she could get.
You should not be doing this at X weeks pregnant.
She spent a summer building houses in Calcutta, where she met my dad, Sanjay.
Ah.
My mom moved to India a week after graduation and got a job teaching English. Lewis was born a year later.
Which one was Lewis? Do we know how Lewis died?
When my dad died, I don't think Mom knew where else to go. I'm sure Edie was happy to have her back. And to see kids in the house again. The house had to get a little bigger, but Edie was used to that.
Oh, homeschooled.
Things were good. Almost normal.
Barbara Gus sent... Lewis. Lols. Oh, wait. I think that's meant to be rules. I will never not read that as lols now, though.
But it didn't last.
Anything here? That is us, I guess. Great job.
Beginning of the end was Milton's 10th birthday, when Edie gave him a castle.
There's gonna be a secret way in, right? Oh, well, just a regular way in. I'm almost disappointed. Painted a door. Like a cool kid.
I think Edie was happy to finally have another painter in the family.
I wish I had all this stuff as a kid. Ah, that guy's cool. He's not dead. Maybe.
Milton Finch in the magic paintbrush.
That explains why there's a paintbrush on his grave. I don't think the flipbook is that long, but this is cool. That's the door he drew downstairs. That's where he went missing. I wonder.
I was 4 when Milton disappeared.
You're about to find him.
Mom spent months searching for my brother. Then she sealed the doors.
And come on. Eh. Eh. Open. Sesame. Knock, knock. Damn it.
Whatever Milton had found in the house, Mom didn't want it getting out.
And what have we here? Absolutely. Waste of my valuable 2-hour walking time. Okay. Actually, I'm going to leave it there for today. We found out more about family. Who have we found out? We found out Milton, Gus, Gregory. We knew Kevin last time. Sam and Walter. So we've got Edie, Dawn and Lewis left. And maybe more. Who knows? We'll get to that next time. So until we see you again, later.